In this tutorial, I'll demonstrate two ways to add a snow effect to a photo. The first method uses a pattern fill, and the second uses a noise effect. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also download a written copy of this tutorial. Here's the photo I'm starting with. It's important to note that for both methods I'll be demonstrating, the size of your original photo plays a large role in how the snow effects will appear. You'll probably have to adjust settings and scales to get the effects you want. For the first snow method, I'll create a new, small image which starts with a transparent background. I'll add a second raster layer, and with the bottom layer active, I'll flood fill the layer with black. This will make it easier to see the snow pattern I'm about to add on the layer above. Now I'll make the top layer active, activate the paintbrush, and set the color to white. I'm using the default round brush with low hardness, and I'll click to place random white paint spots. I can change the brush size by dragging while holding the Alt key. I'll turn off the black layer to leave only the white paint dots. The title of this image is Image 1. Returning to my photo, I'll add a raster layer above the background, which will contain the snow effect. I'll activate Flood Fill and click the color swatch. I want to apply a pattern, which I'll take from Image 1. I'm not sure of the scale yet, so I'll click OK to try out this pattern, then click the image to flood fill the layer with the snow pattern. The snow is a little dense, and I can see the pattern repeat because my original photo is much larger than the pattern image. So I'll undo and go back to the pattern properties. After increasing the scale a bit and repainting, the snow looks great. The snow already looks a little blurry because of the softness of the paintbrush, but I can blur a bit more by choosing Adjust, Blur, and try out a Gaussian blur. Because Preview on Image is checked, I can test out different radius values. If I want more dense and random-looking snow, I can duplicate the existing snow layer. With that layer selected, I'll expand the image canvas and use the Pick tool, set to Scale Mode, to enlarge the copied layer. Now we've got ourselves a blizzard. The second snow effect method will have a slightly more natural appearance. I'll turn off the snow layers and add a new raster layer called Noise. The noise effect is rather dense, so with the selection tool, I'll select about a quarter of the photo. Once I've set up the noise, I'll scale it up to fit the rest of the image. I'll first flood fill the selected area with white, press Ctrl D to deselect, then zoom in so I'll be able to see the noise I'm adding. I'll choose Adjust, Add Remove Noise, Add Noise. I could get good results with any of the noise types, but I'll choose Random and check Monochrome so the noise will be shades of gray. A density of about 3% works well with the size of this particular image, though I could increase the density for heavier snow. If I wanted to greatly reduce the noise density, I could choose Adjust, Brightness and Contrast, Threshold, and find a value at which most of the dots disappear. But I want to keep my snow rather dense, so I'll leave the noise as is. With the noise layer still active, I'll activate the Pick tool, make sure the mode is set to Scale, and expand the noise area to cover the photo. Now I need to remove the white background of this layer. I'm using the magic wand with RGB value as the match mode and zero tolerance so that no other color but white will be selected. I'll click on any white spot to select all of the white, then press Delete to remove all of the white. After deselecting, what remains on this layer is the noise in shades of gray, which I'll change to all white. I'll choose Adjust, Brightness and Contrast, Brightness Contrast, and set the brightness to the maximum value. Now I can add a motion blur with a strength value around 15 to make it look like the snow is coming down. These snowflakes are a bit small, so I'll expand the image canvas and use the Pick tool to enlarge the noise. Now let's say I want to save this snowy noise effect to place on another image. If that image were open alongside the image with the effect, I could simply drag the noise layer from its image into the new image and size with the Pick tool if needed. Or, if I don't have another photo ready for snow yet, I can save the noise layer as its own image. I'll drag the noise layer into blank space and use File, Save As to save it in PNG format, since this format supports transparency. Then when I have an image ready for snow, I'll have that image plus my saved PNG image open at the same time, and I'll drag the noise layer into the image. This brings us to the end of this tutorial on snow effects in PaintShop Pro. If you've been watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also download a written copy of this tutorial.